Hello and welcome back to Shakespeare. We are working on The Merchant of Venice, and today we get to hear from Antonio in Act 4, Scene 1. Antonio is currently kind of sort of on trial because all of the ships that he was counting on to come back with money that he would use to pay Shylock back were shipwrecked. So he is unable to pay back the money that he borrowed from Shylock that he lent to Bassanio so Bassanio could woo Portia. Bassanio married Portia. Bassanio was there to like be moral support at this whole trial, that kind of a thing. And when we kicked off the trial, we had the Duke saying to Shylock, like, everybody thinks that you're just psyching everyone out. And when it comes right down to it, you're going to forgive Antonio. You're not going to demand this pound of flesh. And you might even, you know, waive some of the fees that he owes you, that kind of a thing, because you know what bad luck he ran into. And yesterday we had Shylock saying that no, he just hates Antonio that much that he would rather have the pound of flesh. And whether or not you think he's justified in hating Antonio, maybe you think their mutual hatred is justified because, you know, Shylock charging interest on money that he would lend out at the time was maybe even illegal. But Antonio was also like bad-mouthing Shylock in front of all of the people that Shylock would want to do business with. So there's been a lot of animosity between the two of them for an extraordinarily long period of time. And Shylock is sick of it. So yesterday he was like, nope, I want my pound of flesh and I don't have to justify it to you. He signed documents saying he would give me a pound of flesh if he can't pay me back, and he can't pay me back. So I want my pound of flesh. And Bassanio was like, well, he owes you 3,000 ducats, here's 6. And Shylock is like, cube that. Make each of those 6,000 ducats 6, and then make each of those 6, and I still would rather have the pound of flesh. And they're like, what can we do to make this better? And Antonio speaks up and says, I pray you think, you question with the Jew. You may as well go stand upon the beach and bid the main flood bait his usual height. Or even as well, use question with the wolf, the ewe bleat for the lamb. You may as well forbid the mountain pines to wag their high tops and to make no noise when they are fretted with the gusts of heaven. You may as well do anything most hard as seek to soften that, then which, what harder? His Jewish heart. Therefore, I do beseech you, make no more offers, use no farther means, but with all brief and plain convenience, let me have judgment and the Jew his will. So what he's saying here is he has zero faith that Shylock will listen to reason or listen to anybody's complaints or offers of more money or any of that sort of thing. He's like, it's just as easy to tell the trees to not bend in the wind as it is to get Shylock to give anything here. So let's stop with all the pleading, let's stop with all the bargaining, all that kind of stuff, and just get this over with. Let's just give him what he wants. And tomorrow, the rest of the people don't necessarily listen, and they try like one more time, but then Shylock has some more to say tomorrow about getting his bond. There's like 2 lines in between, so it's not an immediate response, but it's not like tons of plot unfolds between today's monologue and tomorrow's monologue, but just suffice it to say, Shylock has a few more things to say in response to Antonio here, which, in fairness, I would too. I'm curious to know who other people think the protagonist is at this point. Like, are you on Shylock's side? Are you on Antonio and Bassanio's side? Like, I feel like this monologue by Antonio is particularly mean. Shylock has also been particularly mean. It's gonna get real icky. It's gonna get real icky real soon. Sorry about that. But we'll get to hear more from Shylock tomorrow. So I'll see you then for that. Mwah.